out front now, the former director of national intelligence under President Obama, General James Clapper. General Clapper, great to have you with me again. So the president, you heard it, right? He says the Russia investigation is a hoax, hours after parading his intelligence chiefs out, all of whom said the opposite. Why does he demean them like that, do you think?
Well, I think, you know, whatever else you say about all of his inconsistencies, one thing he's been consistent about ever since we briefed him in January 17 about the Russian meddling is he just cannot get his head around the fact of the Russian meddling and the evidence for which was just overwhelming because it casts doubt on the legitimacy of his election. And he certainly appears to me can never acknowledge that to his base, who he was obviously playing to in his rally at Wilkes-Barre.
Now, CNN counterterrorism analyst Phil Mudd earlier today said this was all just a PR stunt. And I know you know Phil. He put it very bluntly. Here he is.
Let's be clear. That was not a security meeting yesterday.
So that was just a PR stunt.
That was a PR stunt. Give me a break. Yes. They got used.
Do you agree?
Well, I think I'd take issue a little bit with my good friend Phil Mudd on this. I thought actually it was pretty compelling to have. I mean, yeah, it had a PR aura about it just because it was in the White House press room. But I thought the messages that were conveyed all down the line by essentially the heavy artillery in the national security arena was pretty compelling. And I thought that all of their statements were genuine and sincere. And they all made the point one way or another that Russia poses
a
profound
threat.
So you believe
them, but did they get used by their boss?
Well, as subsequent events would indicate, they certainly got, as Jennifer Rubin, The Washington Post, indicated, got hung out to dry big time. Mm-hmm. And I was just trying to imagine what I would have felt like it were I in still in Dan Coats' shoes or in that position. Had that happened to me in the last administration.
So let me ask you something about Dan Coats, because, you know, today the Russians called the U.S. focus on Russian hacking hysteria. They like to use that word. It has been 3 weeks, right, since the whole Helsinki summit. Dan Coats, who replaced you as DNI chief, has just said, he is still not able to talk about what happened in that one-on-one meeting. He just doesn't know, right? But that is completely different than what the Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has said. I want to play both of them for you.
I'm not in a position to either understand fully or talk about what happened at Helsinki.
I've had a number of conversations with President Trump about what transpired in the meeting. I think I have a pretty complete understanding of what took place
in that
meeting.
So, General, can you think of any reason why the National Intelligence Chief, right, the top intelligence advisor to the President of the United States, Dan Coats, is in the dark on that meeting? He's been very open about it twice now. When the Secretary of State says, I'm confident Trump's told me what happened, he's telling one but not the other?
Well, I obviously can't explain it. I think it is terrible commentary, actually, on this whole Helsinki fiasco. What should have happened was convene a meeting of the National Security Council, particularly the national, you know, those directly involved in this, Secretary of State, Secretary of Defense, the DNI, et cetera, and get a very thorough debriefing on what happened. And apparently, I don't know, maybe the president's playing favorites with his Secretary of State, who he does have an affinity with.
Yeah.
But I think it's a sad commentary when the DNI is cut out of this. And to Dan's great credit, he's been completely honest about it and public about it.
Yes, he certainly has been. I want to ask you, because you mentioned briefing, obviously, now President Trump and then President Obama in January 2017, right, which in part was about that dossier. I know you personally weren't a part of, that word for word, right, but you were, you know, in that group of intelligence chiefs. Federal government is now, a judge is ruled, going to have to tell BuzzFeed whether you, Brennan, Comey, Admiral Rogers, briefed President Obama before BuzzFeed published the dossier, which, of course, was on January 10th. Now, I believe you've been clear about that, right? That briefing did happen before January 10th, right?
If you're speaking of the briefing to President Obama, yes.
Okay, so I guess the big question for you is, when you look at this now and what's happened now and what is still unverified in that dossier, do you have any problem with the fact that BuzzFeed published it?
Well, you know, the media is going to do what it's going to do. It wasn't an intelligence document per se. That was a call on their part. We knew that that actually that dossier was widely distributed, that lots of people had it in the run-up to the briefing. And the only reason in the no good deed goes unpunished department, we thought that the president-elect at the time, Trump, should know about the existence of the dossier and what was in it. And then we tried to be as discreet about that as possible, ergo necking down to just Jim Comey and the president-elect after the formal briefing on the intelligence community assessment, which did not include findings from the dossier.
All right. Well, thank you very much, General Clapper. I appreciate your time as always, sir.
Thanks, Aaron.